So my name is Rob Horricks. I'm the CEO of Blushlight Organics. I'm also an orchardist. This is my orchard in Terminus, British Columbia. So we grow organically there. We've been doing it for 9 years. And the land's been organic for 25 years, something like that. So, our valley here, the Smoking Valley, is actually the number one organic growing area in Canada. Most of the organic apples are grown in this valley that are sold throughout Canada. So it's a very, very important area. Starting to be some more in the Okanagan, but this is a very important place. I'm going to talk to you briefly about this, the GM apple. And this is a sign that we put up this year on Highway 3, and it is important to the whole community. So we put it at the beginning of our place. It's not right at our place, it's actually just afterwards. So it's halfway between us and a non-organic orchard, because this is an issue that affects everybody. It especially affects everybody because of the potential contamination to our ecosystem and spreading of these genetics in through pollen. There's obviously the questions of health over the long period that we don't really know about, and especially for these people here, the damage to the image of an apple in the market, in BC, nationally, and really around the world with all consumers. So, what is this all about? There's a thing called the Arctic apple, and some people may have heard of it. It's basically genetically modified not to brown when cut, and it's a business that is based in Canada with technology licensed from Australia, and is being tested in the United States. So in one way or another, they're able to do a little bit of each puzzle in different countries. They can own it here, test it in the States, grow it somewhere else, and they're basically finding lots of loopholes through stuff. It's developed by a company called Okanagan Specialty Fruits out of Summerland, which is a really unfortunate thing, because also in Summerland there is a research station, a very incredible research station called Pacific Agricultural Research Station. So there is confusion that happens with that, and at this research station, a lot of good varieties through hybridization do come up. So it's very damaging to the image of that too. And it's basically all of apples. So it's an apple that will not brown when cut. Now the issue with this is that farmers will not growth. Really, they're not going to bother. Stuff that you're going to process is going to be your stuff that's not your number one grade. It has dings and stuff on it. It's not perfect. So there's really what we call culls is what would be used for processing. There's not really a market for it. And the other thing is, if it's bruised, you will not see it as a consumer. So someone could lob it 6 feet into an apple bin, it's going to end up on the shelf 6 months later, and it will look normal. Believe it or not, you will not see bruising on the apple. So it's really quite a ripoff to consumers. And essentially the only one that's going to benefit is the person who can buy it from it. So, both organic and non-organic growers are against this. This is not a one-sided issue. In fact, the BC Fruit Growers Association, which is the largest apple organization in British Columbia, possibly Canada, and it came out with a statement November last year, asked the government for immediate moratorium on the GM apple, known under the trademark Arctic apple. For them, their concern is the negative publicity for apples in general caused by the controversy over this GM apple. There's potential market damage caused to apple markets if this GM apple is approved. Indeed, it seems the damage is occurring even while the apple is in the regulatory process, and a decision on its approval is still pending. The public thinks of apples as pure, natural, healthy, and nutritional fruit. GM apples are a risk to our market image. That's from the president. In their survey that it did in 2012 in partnership with Quebec Apple Producers Association, it showed that 69% of Canadians are not in favor of GM food, and 91% of them said GM labeling should be mandatory. Quote saying, if 76% of the people of the Canadian government, if 76% of people say the Canadian government has not provided adequate information to the public on GM foods, how can the government then approve these products for introduction into an unprepared marketplace? This places the entire apple market at risk, and we have asked that the government place an immediate preemptive moratorium on this apple before our markets suffer. This is not wanted by the growers around the world. In National Post article in November last year titled "International Fruit Growers Up in Arms Over Canadian-Designed GM Apple That Cannot Grow." Quite a black eye Canadian apples. The president of the GM Apple Company, Neil Carter, admits that the public doesn't want this apple, and he's quoted saying, "Anti-genetic engineering feelings were already strong in Europe, but we thought North America was going to be smarter than Europe. And consumer attitudes were going to get better, not worse. We made a wrong call there, for sure." Pretty scary quote, the guy admits that he made the wrong call. So, it's a very important thing for the apple industry, and it is something that we can fight and we can win.